What's going on, everybody? Appreciate y'all for tuning back in. And in my honest opinion, we're going to be reviewing the Nike best budgeted shoe of 2024, the Nike GT Cut Academy. I can't take no loss. I don't even know what it costs. Hit the ground and it go off. Yeah, hit the ground and it go off. Yeah, I can't take no loss. I don't even know what it costs. Yeah, hit the ground and it go off. Yeah, hit the ground and it go off. Early disclaimer for a lot of you guys that are just like me. Unfortunately, I was never able to review the Nike GT Cut ones. That's why you guys never seen it on my channel. And I'm not going to pay X amount of money. But I have early disclaimer for you guys. Some of you are just like me that were unable to get the Nike GT Cut ones due to it selling out fast and also due to it costing around $400 to $500 on StockX just to get a pair. Guys aren't going to regret getting the Nike GT Cut Academies. I'm trying to tell y'all, if you weren't able to get the GT Cut ones, get these doppelgangers because they are fire and y'all are about to hear why. Starting stuff, we talk about the sizing and the price, and the sizing I can recommend that you guys go your true to size. If you guys are a wide footer or may want a little bit of extra space, even though you don't need it, you guys can go up half a size, because in my true to size, I'm a size 12 when I was stopping on the dime for dribble pull-ups or whatever the case I was doing. My toe wasn't hitting the toe box, which is always a good sign, because usually you need bigger shoes or wider shoes or more space in your shoes just so your toe doesn't do that. But my toe wasn't doing that at all. I didn't find any uncomfortability around the size of my foot or anything. So like I'm telling you guys, if you guys have more, I guess, traditional standard feet like me per se, you guys can go your true to size. But if you're a wide footer or want a little bit of extra space just in case, you guys can go up half a size. And the pricing for the GT Cut Academy, why I call it a budget shoe, is gonna be $95. And I'm gonna tell y'all this in advance. For how good this shoe is and how good you guys are about to hear it for $95, I'm trying to tell y'all. That's why I'm calling it right now the best Nike budgeted shoe of 2024, because I don't think any other shoe is going to be able to top this for $95. Moving on to the style, I'm going to go ahead and give these a 7 out of 10. The colorway on this shoe didn't really stand out to me as much. I mean, it's a basic colorway of a black, white, and green. And me, I'm more of a vibrant shoe colorway type of guy. So like pink, orange, white, green, blue, you know, stuff like that. Any colorway that stands out, that's usually going to be the one that's going to catch my eye. So trust and believe, I will be keeping my eye on the Nike app just to see what other colorways they release of this shoe. I feel like they're going to drop some heat. I hope they drop some heat, like some pink, some blue, you know what I'm saying, of this colorway, and I'm definitely going to cop that. The materials on the shoe feel good as well, even though it's a budgeted shoe, so it's going to be budgeted materials. The materials feel very solid as well. And in my honest opinion, this is definitely the budgeted version of the GT Cut one. So I'm trying to tell y'all, definitely go ahead and cop you guys this shoe. They have a white and red colorway as well as this one, but if you guys want to wait like me, maybe like probably like a couple weeks down the line, they're probably going to drop some more colorways. Maybe nothing like the GT Cut ones, because they had the USA colorway that I wanted, some pink ones, some blue ones. But hopefully they drop something similar in a budgeted version of that colorway. I'm definitely going to cop. But yeah, the style on this, colorway on this is a basic one, but I'm hoping for much better colorways in the future. Up next, as a lot of you guys already know, we have my favorite category, which is the cushion. And I'm going to go ahead and give these a 9 out of 10. And yeah, y'all heard me right. These are a 9 out of 10. Inside the shoe, you guys are going to get Air Zoom, as well as in the midsole, you guys are going to get 2 double stacks foam. And you guys are going to get a boost off of the ground, really good amount of impact force protection upon jumping and landing, as well as you guys look at the bottom shoe here, it looks like the Giannis 4s, which is going to give you that spring and explosion out the balls of your feet, as well as you guys are also going to get a Zoom Air unit at the back of the foot where the heel is. So this shoe is definitely a cushion monster. So if you guys love cushion, spring, bounce, boost off of the ground, a really good amount of impact force protection upon jumping and landing, I'm trying to tell y'all right now, this is something that you guys are going to go for. As well as if you guys play outside, if your local gym is closed or whatever the case may be, or you're hooping outside in tournaments, you can definitely take this outside as well, because it's definitely going to be able to protect you cushion wise against the asphalt. You guys already know asphalt is not the best for your knees, but this is definitely going to help you. So while the cushion was on my foot, it felt amazing. I could walk away with no complaints. I had the spring I wanted, the bounce I wanted, the boost off of the ground, the impact force. I had everything that I wanted. So if you're an athletic player, a player with sneaky bounce, or a very springy player, this shoe is definitely going to benefit you, especially if you like to slash and catch alley-oops and whatever the case may be. It's definitely going to benefit you. Also, somebody that doesn't really have that much bounce and that much spring and all that other stuff, this shoe is definitely going to benefit you as well, because the cushion is just that good. So honestly, if you got bounce, if you don't got bounce, this cushion setup is definitely going to be the one for you. It's definitely going to be the one for me, that you guys go ahead and look towards getting this GT Cut Academy, because the cushion is stellar, and I cannot continue to say that inside and outside. Also, I forgot to mention to you guys, this shoe is lightweight, but I wanted to tell you guys, if you wanted to take this beyond the basketball court, it's a lifestyle shoe. If you like to run outside and stuff like that, you guys can. I know the Puma Stewies are a basketball shoe, but I gave those to my mom, because at the bottom of her feet, sometimes she has like, they get like swollen, it becomes uncomfortable for her to walk. But the cushion inside that shoe is so good that she decided to take it as a lifestyle shoe, because obviously she doesn't play basketball like that. But I just wanted to tell you guys that you guys can take this as a runner, or you can take this as a lifestyle, whether you jog, whether you work, whatever the case may be, you guys could be able to take this off the court and on the court. So that's just food for thought if you guys ever wanted to know something. Moving on to the support of the GT Cut Academy, I'm gonna go ahead and give these a 9 out of 10. Inside the shoe, you guys are gonna get a decent amount of padding. Actually, you guys are gonna get a good amount of padding around the ankle bone and Achilles heel, a decent amount of padding inside the tongue. But where this shoe is gonna be very strong at is around that ankle security. The snuggability inside this shoe is crazy. I'm telling y'all, that ankle isn't going anywhere once you tie it to the tightest. And if you even wanted even more security, there's 2 extra lacing holes that you guys can go in. Not saying that you need it, you really don't need it, because the security around this shoe is definitely top tier. Now I will say, it is a low cut shoe, and I want to stress this to some of you guys, because some of you guys are like me. I am prone to ankle sprains. I don't know why, it's just one of my nagging injuries that I get. You just have to be careful, because it is a low cut shoe and they're not always the best at being able to stop a sprain from being a little bit worse, if that makes any sense. I don't want to discourage you from it, but I just want to put attention to it because it is a low cut shoe. Because most of my shoes are midfoot, like the Jaws, the LeBron 20s, the LeBron 21s, the Kobe 6s, the Dame 8, some of the KDs, I have more midfoot just for that reason. But I do like this shoe because it is lightweight and it is low cut. And honestly, the lowest cut shoe that I have is the Sears Player Only, the Player One, and it sits lower than this, and I perform great inside this shoe. I don't wear it all the time, but I do wear it a really, really good amount of the time. So that's just food for thought. If I had to give you guys 3 NBA players that I feel fit the play style of this shoe, it would be De'Aaron Fox, Ja Morant, and Tyrese Maxey. And what do those 3 all have in common? They quick as hell, athletic, and also they can change the direction like that. Now, obviously this shoe can fit many other play styles. If you're a shooter, maybe even if you wanna go post up, if you're a defender, because it is gonna have that security around the ankle. Those 3 type of play styles, if you guys have anything similar like that, it's definitely gonna benefit you even better. Cause I'm more so like that, more change of direction, more attacking downhill, quick. So I need something that's gonna be able to hold me up, cause I be gunning on that fast breaker, gunning when I see the lane on the half court side. So yeah, I think if you have a play style like that, then it's definitely gonna benefit you a lot more than it would various other play styles, if that makes sense. And last on the list, we have the traction, and I'm gonna give these a 9 out of 10. You guys are gonna hear squeaking on these like crazy. And the traction pattern on the Academies is a herringbone as well as a multi-traction design. So if you guys are gonna play with this shoe on a clean court, it's gonna perform great. On a dusty court, it's even still gonna perform great. On a very, very, very dusty court, like they never keep up with it, this shoe is still gonna perform at a top tier level, as well as you guys can take this shoe outside, because it's gonna perform really good on asphalt, dust, dirt, and debris, whatever else comes outside. So this is definitely one of the ones that Nike created that can perform in and out. That's why I said, you guys, if you wanted to run, or if you want a lifestyle shoe, you guys can take it out there as well. Now, when I mentioned before earlier with De'Aaron Fox, Ja, and Tyrese Maxey, this shoe just looks like it's built for quick. Quick, change of pace, slashing, step backs. If you have that type of game, like a Luka type game, this shoe is definitely gonna perform and play like that for that type of play style. So I think this shoe is definitely very guard friendly. If you're like a big man per se, I don't know if it'll be able to perform you like that, because it's lightweight. I don't know. I've never been a big man. I'll never be a big man in my life. So I don't know if you guys would want to dabble in this. You could if you want. But if you're a guard, shifty, fast, change of pace, this shoe is definitely going to be one you guys want to look out for, especially for $95. But don't let that discourage you if you don't have that quick change of pace type of play style. If you're a shooter, lockdown, two-way, whatever the case may be, pass it. You guys can't go ahead and wear this, because the traction pattern is that good. It can seep over to other play styles. But I just think primary, like everything has like a primary and secondary. I think primary play styles, quick change of direction, and athletic, just definitely is gonna benefit you. Ending it off, we have the ranking of the GT Cut Academy, and I'm gonna go ahead and give these an A+. Yes, y'all heard it, man. I was not expecting this shoe to be that good, but this shoe is really that good. Probably because it's like the little brother or the doppelganger of the GT Cut ones. But yes, A+ for this shoe. The style, like I said, is pretty basic. It's nothing too crazy. The price alone, the fact that this shoe is $95 and it's been better than some shoes that I reviewed this past year that cost like $160, $150 and up, it's really crazy. So let that stay in mind. It's like a budget type of shoe, and it's an A+. The cushion alone inside the shoe, this cushion is definitely one of my favorites inside. You guys get that boost off of the ground, a really good amount of impact force protection upon jumping and landing, as well as you guys are running and doing Euro steps and stuff like that, you guys are gonna get that spring and explosion out this part of the foot, as well as inside the heel, you guys are gonna have that compression just in case that some of y'all might land on your heel or whatever the case may be. You guys are gonna be able to get that really good amount of impact force back there as well. Traction is really good. It's gonna fight off dust, perform great on a clean court, great on a dusty court. And also it's a very, very, very dusty court. It's definitely gonna be able to perform very good as well. And you guys can also dabble and take the shoe outside. So yeah, Nike, y'all did one with this. I'm trying to tell y'all, cop the Nike GT Cut Academy, or if you want better colorways, stay tuned, because they probably are going to drop. But yeah, this shoe is definitely one of them ones, and I'm going to go ahead and get out of here and have Chauncey send us out, and I'm gonna see y'all on the next one.
You got anything you want to add to it, Chauncey? What? Is that your end intro?
Yeah, just the end intro.
Thank you for guys watching today's video. See you next in today's video. Bye.